Hello YouTubers. In this video today, what I'm going to do, I'm going to go over the features and the capability of this Calog Loadcell II Calibrator. So as you'll note, I posted that video on Process Control Network. So if you want a bit of background as to why this device is so handy and so useful, go and have a look at that video. I'll annotate it here. And then you can come back and see what this device is all about. But basically, we're going to show how this can be used to test a load cell. It can check the insulation. It can show the operation in place. And it can simulate a load cell back to a process control system for troubleshooting. So let's get stuck in and do a straightforward load cell test. Okay, so we've got the load cell actually in place here. So this could be in a production environment where you're kind of weighing things and you need to test, you might have an issue and you need to actually test your load cell. So the unique thing about this device is that you can do these tests with your load cell in place. What I'm going to do to make it easy for the camera work, I'm going to take this down and put it next to the load cell tester itself so we can see what's going on with the wiring, what have you. So there's a look at the load cell itself, and I'll take it down now so that we can have a closer look at it for the testing. Okay, so the first test I'm going to do is to actually check that the load cell still conforms to its specifications. Now, just a bit of background information as to where these this particular product can be bought, because they're fairly unique. As I said, they are produced in South Africa. There's a company called Instrotech, and they are the people who actually designed and built this device, which is fairly unique in terms of load cell measurement and testing. So what you get with your load cell transducer is a spec sheet, a kind of calibration and test of it when it was produced. Now, as you see, this was actually done way back in 2007, but nonetheless, it's a good example of the kind of some of the important specs for this load cell. As you can see, its rated capacity is 1,000 kilograms, but the interesting bits and pieces we want to see, remember when I was talking about that Wheatstone bridge? There are input and output resistances that we want to check. There's also an insulation resistance, which can indicate whether there's either a short circuit in the load cell itself or whether there's moisture ingress. Then there's the calibration, the zero balance value in millivolts under no load. There's the calibration figure for the gain, in essence, of millivolts versus your excitation, a single volt of excitation voltage. So in essence, if we've got a 10 volt excitation voltage, then you can expect to get 29 point what have you millivolts out of this at full load. They state obviously what length of cable that they had attached, which will be probably the same cable when they actually did the calibration. So let's get down to actually running the tests on this and see how that operates. Okay, so to run that first load cell check, in essence, what we do is we take the wiring from the load cell, and as I said, it's a four wire system. You can have an additional two wires, two sense wires, which provide a bit more accuracy in terms of measuring resistance and the readings across the load cell if you've got long wire runs, but in this case it's a four wire system. So we've got the two external cables attached, which are the excitation voltage, which is in our case is going to be 10 volts. And then you've got the ones which actually get the reading back from the load cell in millivolts, this green and the white one, which are connected into the block here. Right, so we simply power the device on. And straight up it comes to the menu where you can do your load cell test. Now we will go through and I'll explain something, we'll do some of the other tests, but we'll start off with this load cell test. And obviously that's just easily selected on these push buttons here. So we push the enter key, and I'll do a bit of time lapse there. This test takes about 30 seconds. Okay, and as you can see, we have a result. It actually tells us, obviously, that it's a four-wire system. It tells us our zero balance, input resistance, output resistance, and some other readings. But the critical ones I want to note are the ones up here. And as you can see, it gives us this 0.038 millivolt per volt of our zero balance. And if we actually go and look at the spec sheet, we can see this one is out from its date of calibration. But as I said, this was done some time ago. But that check, which you can do in place with an up-to-date spec sheet, then tells you whether your values here are still within spec or potentially whether you've got a problem or not with your load cell. As you can see, the input and the output values are certainly not too far off what they're quoted on the spec sheet itself. So next, what we'll do, we'll run through an installation test, which again is really handy because you can do those tests in place with this device. So you don't have to take your load cell down or what have you, and you can check whether you've got any faults. Let's do the installation test next. Okay, now for the installation test. So in this case, what we're doing, we're making sure that it sends basically 50 volts through to the housing of your load cell, and it tests if there's any issue with the insulation. And obviously the two potential issues is if you have a short circuit anywhere in the wiring, or whether you've got moisture ingress, which could cause an issue. So what we do here then, the extra wire, the fifth wire of the cabling system, is a shield which goes to connector 6, and then this yellow wire I've got connected to this clip to the housing to do a check between the two. So on our Calog Loadcell 2, we just go down, we then go and select the test insulation, hit enter, and it gives you instructions on what you need to remove from the connection block up here, which I've already done. We push enter and off it goes, and it does the test. Okay, and as you can see, it's come back and it's noted the bridge to shield, the bridge to housing, is all greater than 1,000 mega ohms, and the shield to housing is greater than 1,000 mega ohms. So in essence then, our insulation is all fine. But this would then highlight if you had any short circuit or moisture ingress into your load cell at all. Okay, there's a couple of tests which I can't demonstrate here, which I'll just mention, that can be done with this device. So the one is to actually check the weighing system itself. And what you need there is Calog Loadcell 2 acts as a millivolt measurement from the output of the load cell. And what you do, you'd wire up the output of the load cell to this device. It would use the excitation voltage, which would actually come from the load cell transmitter. And what you can do, you can measure all these. You can measure the millivolt output from the load cell, you can measure the milliamp output from the transmitter, and also check that your excitation voltage is correct. So I'll kind of just show you how what that looks like on the display itself. So we go to measure. You then input all your bits of information in here. What you want to do, what your excitation voltage is going to be, and your values. You can see the actual gain value has been brought in from the calibration test itself. And then basically once you hit enter, it then starts a test and it'll display the different values, which obviously it's not doing at the moment, but it can display those values as the for the test. Okay, so the other testing that this can do as well is it can actually simulate the load cell itself and transmit information back to the load cell transmitter to make sure that the load cell transmitter is doing its work correctly and sending its information back in milliamps back to the process control system itself. And then this can also simulate the load cell transmitter so that this sends milliamp information, it sources milliamp information back to the process control system again to actually simulate to make sure you've got no fault in those transmitting systems. But what we're going to do next, we're kind of going to do a load cell calibration where we hang a weight on the load cell itself, and then this acts as the process control system itself in terms of receiving information back from the load cell. So in essence, you see what's coming out of the load cell and the information you should be getting back from your transmitter to your process control system. So we'll set that up now. Okay, so now we're going to actually set up the simulation where this actually acts as the kind of receiving unit, a process control system, to check all the information coming back from a load cell. So what we do there is we go down to load cell display, we enter on that, and then we go and we set up a whole lot of parameters here. So if we have a look at those parameters, we want it to supply an excitation voltage. It already has our gain in there. I've gone and set the decimal point so that it measures up to 0.1. And what we need to do is test, provide it some, let it do a zero to test that it's going to be all right. So if we go down, because we've got a little hook attached to it, we want to make sure that we zero trim it. This other information, filter band and the filter time, is a time basically to let that load cell settle. And again, that's something I discussed in the video when I was explaining process control networks. But now what we're going to do, we enter on the zero trim. So what it does now, it checks the output of the load cell to see what it is, to use that as a reference as zero. Okay. Once it's done that, the next thing is to enter, is to put a test weight on the system. And so this in essence acts as a kind of calibration weight. Now what I've got is this 25 liter container filled with water. And in fact, there must be close to 30 liters or 28 liters because it weighs about 28 kilograms. Well, there is a chain, and obviously the weight of the container itself. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to hoist that up onto the hook, I then enter its weight, and then off we go. Okay, so I've gone and hoisted that onto the load cell itself, and as I put it on, I put it on very gently because I didn't want to have any of the shock to kind of unsettle the actual load cell itself. That's something that's very important when you are calibrating or setting these things up. We now go over here, and entering the information on this device is very easy because I give you these push buttons to actually enter the values themselves. So I know it's exactly 28, there is no point. I'll say exactly, I did this on a bathroom scale, but in essence this is just for to kind of illustrate. So I've entered the value of 28 kilograms of our test load. So that's all done, and now if I just push the enter key, we now actually get our load cell display. So this is what I was demonstrating when I had kind of my bicycle and everything hung up there the other day. But as you can see, it's got now a clear representation of the output from the load cell itself, the actual weight, the millivolt output, and what have you. So if I actually hang on this chain, you'll see the values going up. And that then, this is literally acting as the kind of receiving end of all those signals from the load cell, from the load cell transmitter, to show what should be displayed back on the process control system themselves. And this is all done in place. So that's the beauty of this device. It's got lithium batteries in it, which is able to provide that 50 volts for that insulation test. And all these other tests can be done in place, which is fairly unique to this device itself. Okay, and just to show you some of the other quite handy features that this device actually has. It has a data logging feature, so you can insert an SD card and the outputs and displayed values from your load cell can be logged with a time and date stamp. And it's got a USB port, which then allows you to download these measurements to a PC as well.
It's obviously, you can go and set the settings for the contrast of the screen and everything else. It's got an online help, which in fact gives you a brilliant little readout help of how to wire this device up when you're checking your load cell and what have you. So it certainly is very intuitive help system they've actually got built into this. And then it even has a conversion system where you can convert different mass values from metric to what have you. Change them up and down on the keys here, and then input your values with these keys and do the conversion for you.
Okay, so I hope you will have found that interesting if you are interested in these little devices and what they can do. As I say, I've been really pleasantly surprised about the capability of this device in particular, and what can be done on a process control network in terms of troubleshooting, simulating different devices and what have you with this, and doing checks of a load cell. If you do want more information on this Calog Loadcell 2, I will put in the details below this video, I'll put links to both Instrotech, who are the designers and producers of this locally in South Africa. They certainly do export and have a market overseas, so if you are interested, they do cater for an overseas market. And then Comtest as well will certainly assist you as well if you do have any queries or what have you. But if you have any queries in regards to what I've covered in this video, then certainly post a comment and what have you, and I'll get back to you. Anyway, thanks very much for watching, and certainly if you do enjoy these series, please do subscribe and give them a thumbs up if you enjoy any of the content or you gain any value. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.